Today, we're going to be talking about the Just Wright knife, also known as the LT Wright Lagom bush knife. Now, as the name means in Swedish, Lagom or Lagom, however you want to pronounce that, means just right. And I don't think that they could have found a more fitting name for this tiny little guy called the Lagom. I think that this may just be one of those legendary knives that truly lives up to its title and its love and use by Morris Kohansky. Okay, let's get into this. So for those who don't know already on the channel, you've probably seen the Lagom around a little bit, and you've probably seen me talking about it, using it, and it has admittedly been my primary go-to bushcrafting knife whenever I'm going into the woods, and for some good reasons. One, I've honestly been testing it, and two, the more I test this knife, the more I find out that while it's not the largest or the smallest blade of the bunch, it has a lot of properties that make it very capable for its size. So let's jump into the Lagom. From a standpoint of me just looking at this knife, I have to say that this is one of those rare exceptions of a knife that when I look at it, it doesn't necessarily strike me as a knife that would be amazing. And in the beginning, it doesn't necessarily feel like a knife that would be amazing to use or amazing to carry. But as you use it more and more, you'll find out that the Lagom is one of those few knives that makes you truly a better bushcrafter, which is hard to say because I like to think that I'm a fairly skilled individual. Whenever I pick up the Lagom, I feel like when it comes to knife craft skills, my capabilities improve. And I don't necessarily want to say that I go up to being a legendary bushcrafter and I'm only, you know, a average bushcrafter. I am fairly skilled, but being able to utilize this knife does make me a better bushcrafter, and using it allows me to do more than other knives would. Okay, so now let's take a look at the pros, and then we'll take a look at the cons. So the biggest pros for me have to start out with the size of the knife, which once again is just right, so to speak. Then I would have to say the materials of the overall blade construction being 01 tool steel, G10 handles, and then next being the sheath. This is a pretty awesome sheath, and I'll touch on this a little bit more a little bit later. So next would be value, credibility, and design. So what do I mean by value? Now, this is by no means a cheap knife. It is close to $200, but when I talk about value, this is something I'm going to be touching on a little bit more in just a few minutes. But I think for what you're paying for and for what competition that is out there at this price range, you're actually getting a pretty good deal. To credibility, this is where I mean that the people that went into designing the Lagom were not amateur bushcrafters. You had people like Morris Kohansky, people at LT Wright, and people at Ben's Backwoods, who sells this knife, all collaborated to make this amazing knife. So we have some really truly good bushcrafters that put their brains together to build a knife that would work very well for the forested areas, especially the taiga or boreal forest realms and regions. So lastly are the capabilities. Now this plays into the design and credibility of the knife, but its capabilities are very good. When you take a look at this knife, you'd probably think it's a little bit too small to do a lot of tasks, but it's certainly an industrial knife that can easily baton, easily make feather sticks, easily skin, dress game animals, and do just about any task that you need it to do. In addition, this is a knife that, due to its size and its design, and really its heritage being inspired by Puukko-styled knives from Scandinavia, is a knife that's very well adapted to the Alaskan forests. In addition to that, it's also adapted very well to any boreal forests, whether they be in Russia, Norway, Sweden, you know, the whole Scandinavian area, Canada, Alaska. This is a knife that is very purpose-driven to perform well for the needs and the uses of people up here in the boreal forest regions. Okay, now let's talk about some of the cons to this knife. The first one for me is going to be size. Now that may sound a little bit funny because I just gave that as a pro, but I will say that while it's not a full-on con for me, and I don't think that it necessarily is a detractor, this knife is sitting right there on the very edge where it's almost too big to be a solid neck knife, but it does just narrowly slide in there. And I think that is for the better because this is still a pretty awesome blade. So the next ones are definitely going to be a little bit more practical for cons. These aren't necessarily criticizations or criticizing. This isn't criticizing the blade itself, but rather these elements that go into procuring one. So the first one is availability. These knives, unfortunately, as much as I hate to do a review on something that's hard to get, these knives are very hard to get. They're very hard to find, and Ben's Backwoods is the only place you can get them from as a retailer, and they're only made in small batches, and I actually just lucked out getting mine because mine was like the last of the last knives of a batch. So these knives are extremely hard to procure, which is definitely a con for me, because what's the point of an amazingly designed and engineered knife if you can never get your hands on it? So then next to that is the lack of options. Now, there are a few handle options for this blade, and that is certainly great, but there really is no other steel options. It's only 01, which 01 by no means is a bad steel, but there, just be aware when you do get this knife, you know, you have about four handle options to choose from, and you get one steel option to choose from. Now, I don't think that that's a large enough factor to dissuade myself, especially from getting one, and I certainly would recommend getting one yourself if you can, because 01 is still a great and very well-proven bushcraft steel, but just be aware that there aren't many options for this knife. So lastly, and I struggle to make this a con, but the ergonomics of this knife, because they are a modified version of a Puko, they feel a little bit weird in the beginning and they're not the most comfortable. However, one thing that I will say is as you do use this blade, the ergonomics do improve and they actually are really good. I've talked about this in previous videos, that one of the biggest upsides to knives such as the Eldris by Mora, the Lagom, the Conspool, the Garberg, and a handful of other knives out there, is that it does have a very or reasonably homogeneous blade design or handle design. So what that means is you can hold it like this, and once again, once you get used to it, it's comfortable. This is comfortable. You know, you can pinch grip it. You can hold this knife how you need to. There's no weird or exaggerated ergonomic features to this knife that make it uncomfortable in one or another particular fashion of holding it. And for a bushcrafter, that is a very important thing, as we do tend to hold our knives in multiple different ways, whatever suits us and however we need to hold it to get the job done. So that is one thing that is kind of a hit, but does become more natural as you use it. Okay, so as promised, we were going to talk a little bit more about the sheath. Now, the sheath, I like it a lot. It's not a super thick or heavy-duty sheath. I believe it's made by JRE, which they do a just fine job making sheaths. Now, it does have a dangler on it that is non-removable, and that's something that you're either going to like or you're not. I personally am getting more used to danglers and like them quite a bit, even in a Baldrick rig where it may seem a little bit odd. I think it actually works out well and gives the knife an extra hinge point. In addition to that, it does have space for a ferro rod. I carry a LMF or Light My Fire Army ferro rod on here and it works just fine. The sheath, one thing that does impress me, I'm not sure how the magic that they got this to work like it does, but for a handle, generally with bushcrafting knives, they have a very homogeneous handle. Usually it's very hard to find a sheath that fits well, but this sheath fits this knife like a glove, and it's very hard to come out. This isn't something that's just going to need to like bounce out or rattle right out. You do have to usually use this lanyard, you know, kind of pick it up out of there and be good to go. So I love the retention, and overall this sheath is a great option. Okay, so as I mentioned, lastly in closing, we're going to talk about some of the competitive options and why I think this knife is a good value. So as I mentioned, this knife can be had for around $180 to $160. And what can you get? What else is out there for a similar price range? Well, there's quite a few bushcrafting knives out there for that price point. However, a lot of them are things such as the Bark River Knives Aurora, the Bark River Knives Bushcrafter, and things such as the Battle Horse Knives Battle Lore. And actually, all of those are around $180 to $220, depending on what options and blade steels you get. And those are some of the most comparative options for the Lagom. And once again, the Lagom coming in at $180 to $160 offers a really good price point for something that, honestly, having owned the Bushcrafter, the Aurora, and the Battle Lore, which I still love the Battle Lore, the Aurora, and the Bushcrafter, they're great knives in their own right, but I do think that this actually outperforms them, especially in the consideration of the Battle Lore and the Aurora being slightly larger knives, this one being slightly smaller, slightly lighter, and still retaining a lot of the capability. Makes it a better buy, especially if it's something that you can find available and if it's something that is attractive to you. Another advantage may just be the orange handle as well, and this isn't going to be a selling point for everyone, but the orange handle is another nice touch that is actually unavailable in all the other options mentioned. So it's actually a pretty rare handle option in general, but yeah, so overall, my experience with the Lagom has been very impressive. When I initially got the knife, I didn't really know what to expect. I knew it was a knife that Morris Kohansky had used and had liked and enjoyed. So I was eager to test it and play around with it in the woods, see what it would like, what it would be like in Alaska. And I have to say, if you do live in the boreal forest regions, it makes for one heck of a good knife to use, and it really fills the capacity so long as you're using things like saws, axes, and you're using those other tools in conjunction with this knife. It's a very solid knife to use for general bushcrafting purposes. Anyways, guys, hopefully you've enjoyed this video, and hopefully you've learned something. As always, God bless, and I'm out.